Hello my friends, in this video I'm going to show you how we can make a time-lapse video over a 3D printer. In order to achieve our goal, we need one good picture for every printing layer of the object we print. All we need is a video camera with its external button. We need the time-lapse script of Cura Slicer, and we need to design and print two plastic components to hold and press the external button of the video camera. So let's go. This is the camera I'm going to use. It is a D3100, and this one is the external button which I will use for time lapse. By pressing this button, the video camera takes a picture in the same way by pressing the button on the camera, this one. The external button can be connected to the camera with this plug. Now let me explain you what is the operation of a time-lapse script of Cura Slicer. By the time the printer completes a printing layer, it moves the bed out and the head to the right in the same time. Now we have to design one plastic part in order to hold the external switch right there exactly, and another one plastic part which will hit the button when the head moves to the right, so that the camera can take picture. The external switch of the video camera will be holded over there exactly in this place. This is the first plastic part in which the external switch of the camera will be holded. The external button of the camera will be entered from this upper rectangular shape hole. This part will be mounted through this hole with an M4 Allen bolt and with an M4 T-nut on the X axis. This bigger hole permits me to pass the M4 bolt and tighten this part. I will use the hole below, which is threaded at 5 mm, to keep stable and steady the button of the camera with one M5 bolt. This is the second plastic part which it's used is to hit the external button of the camera when the head goes to the right side. It will be placed over the fan on the right side of the head with instant glue. After I have printed and placed right in their places the two plastic parts, you can see here on the right the part that holds the external button of the camera, and in the left the part that hits the button when the head goes to the right. I stuck this part with instant glue. It will remain there forever. After each layer is finished, the head moves to the right and the part hits the button and the camera takes picture. Here we are in Cura Slicer. I will print this cube in order to make the time lapse. And now let's take a look at the time lapse script in Cura. At the upper bar, I choose extensions, next post processing, modify G code, add script, and we choose time lapse script. In this window we have all those choices. First one is the pose, 700 milliseconds. We energize the park print head. Next choice is park head X. This determines the position that the head will stop. Later in this video I will explain you how we can calculate this. Next one is parkhead y, which determines the position that the bed will stop. I will place it at 235 millimeters and the bed will go all the way out. Let's go find out to the 3D printer the exact position that the head will stop. In order to find the exact position in millimeters where the pin will press the button, first of all I have to press auto home. Second step, I will raise about 5 cm z-axis in order to avoid the head to hit to the clips on the bed. Now, in the move axis menu, I choose x-axis. The number we can see determines the position of the head on x-axis. It is 0 because the head is on the left side. Now, let's move the head 200 millimeters to the right. In this position, we have to find the exact position that the pin hits the button. If we put it to go more to the right, the danger to break the button is very big. From now on, I will move the head to the right with steps of 1 millimeter till I find the exact position the pin presses the button. Exactly here, and the position is 212 millimeters. I have to notice here that this technique eats about 1 centimeter at x-axis, but because I don't have to print something big, I don't mind. Now we are in Cura again at the script, and now I will place the value of 212 millimeters to the parkhead X as we found it previously. Now I press close to this window. As we can see nearby the slicer button, there is an icon which means that the script is energized. Now I slice the item. Save the removable and let's go for printing. So here we are. I have placed the camera in front of the 3D printer. The print will take place exactly in this position as I did in Cura. So I have to focus the camera exactly to that position when the bed is all out. As you can see, I have connected the external button to the camera through its plug, and we are ready to proceed to the printing process. The printing procedure continues. And the only thing we have to wait is the printer to finish the first layer in order to check if the whole procedure worked successfully. We have managed it. The whole process is successful and full operative, and it will be repeated for every printed layer. For every layer, we will have one picture. Next in this video, we will see how we can transform the pictures we have just taken to a single video, the time lapse.
I have copied all the pictures from the camera to my PC exactly in this folder. We are talking about 174 pictures equal to the layers of the cube we just have printed. Now let's go to the YouTube Movie Maker. I have loaded all the pictures and let's place them to the time bar. I click to the left, I choose set duration for each item and I place half a second for each picture. Apply to all and now all the pictures have the same duration of half a second. Now we are ready to burn all this to a video by pressing render. Now I will clean the timeline from previous files and I will load the video file we just have made. As we can see, its duration is 1 minute and 20 seconds. It is very huge. With the right click on the timeline, in this menu I choose playback speed rate and I will choose to play it 4 times faster. Okay, let's make a quick view. I think it's very good. I will leave it like this. Let's render again. I save it with name time lapse 1 as it is my first time lapse. This is the file, the time lapse, which can be used as a part of other videos. This is the first time I make a time lapse, so I couldn't avoid making some mistakes. The first one was the angle of the camera. The camera was too high, it should be lower. And the second one is the zoom, which should be closer to the object I was printing. Also, I have to mention that if we use the time-lapse script, the printing time will last about 30% more.
So, that was a video with how we can make a time-lapse video on the 3D printer. I hope you will find it useful and it will help you to make your own time lapses in case you don't know. From now on, in the videos I will create in the future, there will be a time lapse video. I would like to see your comments below, positive or negative. I would like to see your opinion if I could have done something better. And I want to learn if you have a better way to make time-lapse video. Subscribe, like, share and don't forget to press the button bell just to be informed for new video uploads. Thanks for watching.